Hi everybody, this is Osprey from mychartcoach.com and we are looking at ticker symbol NXTD. Okay, this first chart is a daily chart. Each candle represents one day of trading. As you can see, there was this nice bounce on Friday. The candles on Thursday closed below EMAs 4 and 8 right here. And as you can see, there was a nice move above both levels on Friday. And then there was also a close above the middle Bollinger Band at 0.71. That is the key level to turn into support. And so bulls, you want to see candles forming above the middle Bollinger Band next week and candles riding EMAs 4 and 8 support higher. That will signal the start of a new uptrend. Okay, if the middle Bollinger Band fails to turn into support, that is going to put this gap fill back on deck. So the share price did break out without filling the gap. So there is a space and some unfinished business on the chart. The chart would be stronger if there wasn't the gap. So that's just something to keep an eye on if the chart does break down. But that doesn't mean that the chart that NXTD can't break out and head higher from this pattern. Because it's a very nice move on Friday. And so what we're going to be looking at is for candles to be forming above the middle Bollinger Band. And then you're going to have this resistance level up here is going to be the key level to break from the 19th of January. You want to see a close above this level, and that will signal more upside potential. So that's going to be the key level next week to break. There's a big move between the middle Bollinger Band and then you will have to break the upper Bollinger Band at 105. So that is going to be a key resistance level along with this candle here that formed on the what is that the 26th, I believe. Yeah, I'm outside making this, so it's kind of hard to see. But yeah, on the 26th here will be another key level to break here at 105. And so if that breaks, and that's going to put this candle on the 19th on deck. Okay, very nice start. You've got RSI up here above 50 and in the 50 to 70 bull zone, so that's really good. And now you have Fasto in the 50 to 80 bull zone. Keep an eye out for Fasto above 80. Down here you have EMA4 bullish crossed EMA8. So that's very positive. If you look right here, you can see a bullish crossover. That's an early reversal signal, something that we look out for. Another key development is down here in volume. There's a big volume spike, so that's good. Volume behind the move. As you can see, the spike here, that was some people loading. So what we're looking for now is we're looking down here on MACD for a MACD bullish crossover. We want to see the green line, which is the MACD line, cross the red line, the signal line to the upside. That will signal the start of this new uptrend. Okay, let's look at the next chart. The next chart is another daily chart, and there's a 50, 100, and 200-day moving averages on this chart. As you can see down here, NXTD held the 50-day moving average at 0.50 support level, and then that was it bounced off of that level on Friday. And as you can see, there's a really nice move above the 100-day moving average. So with the close here above the 100-day moving average, that's putting so you've got this close here at 76 above the 100-day moving average. Now that puts the 200-day moving average at 127 on deck. So that is going to be the key level to break after this candle here on the 26th. Okay, let's look at the next chart here. This is a 15-minute chart. Each candle represents 15 minutes of trading. And as you can see, there's this huge breakout. The candle, cl the closing candle here, did form above the upper Bollinger Band. So that was a frothy move into the close. As you can see, this candle formed completely above the upper Bollinger Band. So the candles are going to need to work their way back into the bands. If you look back here on the, what is it, the 11th, going in, what is this, the 12th here, there's this big breakout, and then you can see the candles work back into the bands and then continued heading higher. So we may be looking at that kind of pattern. But yeah, this was just a super bullish move into the close, putting RSI up above 70 and Fasto above 80. And then if you look down here, there was a giant volume behind the move. Look at this huge volume spike going into the close. So that's really bullish. That's setting us up for Monday for more upside potential. There was also a close above this key resistance level here. Let's see here. Yeah, see this high close here on the 12th. There was a close above that level on Friday, so that was the key level, the break. So with the close above, that's signaling more upside potential. Yeah, this was a huge move on Friday. We'll be looking for the 100-day moving average to turn into support on the daily chart, and the middle Bollinger Band to turn into support. We're keeping our eye out for a new uptrend. If for some reason the middle Bollinger Band turns into resistance, and that's going to put the gap on deck, the gap to get filled. So right now we're just looking at more upside potential. We want to see follow through and a potential run to the 200-day moving average. Okay, thanks for viewing this chart. Check us out at mychartcoach.com and at our YouTube channel at mychartcoach.com. Thank you.